الله نزل أحسن الحديث كتابا متشابها مثانية تقشعر منه جلود الذين يخشون ربهم.
السلام عليكم ورحمة الله. الحمد لله رب العالمين، والصلاة والسلام على أشرف المرسلين نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. Welcome to another episode of Quran Circle 9, and we are in Surah Al-Shu'ara. This beautiful surah that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentions in it some of the stories of the prophets of Allah, one after the other, for a great lessons for us. It's signs from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for those who believe and reflect and learn from these stories for their own selves to live their lives according to what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wants from us. We reached page 370, where we recite one page at a time until you get the mushaf and open and to follow inshallah ta'ala with the recitation, because this is the main objective of this program, is to listen to beautiful recitations of the Quran. And I just talk briefly inshallah ta'ala. So before we start, I would like to introduce the reciters with us today. We have Sheikh Ahmed Rajab. Welcome to the program. Sheikh Azad Al-Hawi. Allah barak fik. شيخ طه عزة، شيخ عبد الرازق.
السلام عليكم.
وعليكم السلام ورحمة الله. May Allah سبحانه وتعالى reward you. May Allah سبحانه وتعالى bless this gathering. The gatherings of the Quran are the best gatherings at all times. So let's get to it inshallah تعالى. Page 370. It's the latest of the story of موسى عليه السلام. والشيخ أحمد رجب. Go ahead and recite for us.
أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. فلما تراءى الجمعان قال أصحاب موسى إنا لمدركون قال كلا إن معي ربي سيهدين فأوحينا إلى موسى أن اضرب بعصاك البحر فانفلق فكان كل فرق كالطود العظيم وأزلفنا ثم الآخرين وأنجينا موسى ومن معه أجمعين ثم أغرقنا الآخرين إن في ذلك لآية وما كان أكثرهم مؤمنين وإن ربك لهو العزيز الرحيم واتل عليهم نبأ إبراهيم إذ قال لأبيه وقومه ما تعبدون قالوا نعبد أصناما فنظل لها عاكفين قال هل يسمعونكم إذ تدعون أو ينفعونكم أو يضرون قالوا بل وجدنا آباءنا كذلك يفعلون قال أفرأيتم ما كنتم تعبدون أنتم وآباؤكم الأقدمون فإنهم عدو لي إلا رب العالمين الذي خلقني فهو يهدين والذي هو يطعمني ويسقين وإذا مرضت فهو يشفين والذي يميتني ثم يحيين والذي أطمع أن يغفر لي خطيئتي يوم الدين رب هب لي حكما وألحقني بالصالحين.
بارك الله فيك. يا الله سبحانه وتعالى يقول After Musa عليه السلام and the people, the believers of Bani Israel, when they fled from Pharaoh and his people, they reached a point where the two companies, they can see each other. People of Pharaoh are following them. This is where the page starts with. The people, the companions of Musa عليه السلام, they said, we are overtaken. That's it, because the people of Pharaoh behind them and they're powerful and the sea right in front of them. So Musa alayhi salam, with the certainty and the yaqeen that he has with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he said, nay, indeed, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, my Lord, is with me and he will guide me. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala inspired Musa alayhi salam to strike with his stick to the sea, and it departed into two towering mountains, the like of two towering mountains. And this is such a miraculous thing that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala aided Musa alayhi salam. This it could have been done earlier on. That Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the most wise. The help from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala comes by the will of Allah. After they took all of the means and they reached that stage, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala brought down the help to Musa alayhi salam and the believers. And the people of Fir'aun, they came along, and the people of Musa, they passed to the other side. And then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala willed for the people of Fir'aun to continue in their deviation after seeing this miraculous scene. They still continued to pursue after Musa alayhi salam, but they all were drowned by the power of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So indeed, this is a sign, ayah from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And most of them, they were not believers, as the ayah says. And indeed, your Lord is indeed the Almighty, and He's the most merciful. And then the mention of Ibrahim alayhi salam, when he said to his father and his people, what are you worshipping besides Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? They said that they worship idols, and they are devoted to these idols, images that they made themselves. So Ibrahim alayhi salam, debating with them, inviting them to the tawheed, to the oneness of worship of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, saying to them, these idols, do they hear you when you invoke them? Do they benefit you or they harm you? You know, they said, we found our fathers doing so, so we're following them. And this is basically the disease that is present in many of the human beings on the face of earth today. They just follow the ways of their fathers, regardless, without thinking whether they're doing is what is right or wrong. So he said to them, what you're worshipping besides Allah, you and your forefathers are enemies to you, except Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the Lord of the Alameen, the one that created me, and he's the one that guides me, the one that he gives me food and feeds me and gives me drink. And whenever I'm sick, he is the one that cures me, and the one that makes me die, and he will make me resurrected. And the one that I aspire and I hope that he would forgive my sin in the day of Al-Qiyamah, in the day of Ad-Din, the day of recompense. Then he makes dua to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to give him the wisdom and the ability to rule with wisdom and to make him among the righteous ones. The dua continues with the next page and more of what is mentioned about Ibrahim alayhi salam, and also Nuh alayhi salam will be mentioned. And that is in page 371. Sheikh Asad, go ahead and recite for us.
أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم واجعل لي لسان صدق في الآخرين واجعلني من ورثة جنة النعيم واغفر لأبي إنه كان من الضالين ولا تخزني يوم يبعثون يوم لا ينفع مال ولا بنون ولا تخزني يوم يبعثون يوم لا ينفع مال ولا بنون إلا من أتى الله بقلب سليم وأزلفت الجنة للمتقين وبرزت الجحيم للغاوين وقيل لهم أينما كنتم تعبدون وقيل لهم أينما كنتم تعبدون من دون الله هل ينصرونكم أو ينتصرون فكبكبوا فيها هم والغاوون وجنود إبليس أجمعون قالوا وهم فيها يختصمون قالوا وهم فيها يختصمون تالله إن كنا لفي ضلال مبين إذ نسويكم برب العالمين وما أضلنا إلا المجرمون فما لنا من شافعين ولا صديق حميم فلو أن لنا كرة فنكون من المؤمنين إن في ذلك لآية وما كان أكثرهم مؤمنين وإن ربك لهو العزيز الرحيم كذبت قوم نوح المرسلين إذ قال لهم أخوهم نوح ألا تتقون إني لكم رسول أمين فاتقوا الله وأطيعون وما أسألكم عليه من أجر إن أجري إلا على رب العالمين فاتقوا الله وأطيعون قالوا أنؤمن لك واتبعك الأرذلون
بارك الله فيك إن شاء الله جزاكم الله خيرا Continuing with the dua of Ibrahim alayhi salam, asking Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make him among those who are remembered with honor in the later generations and to make him inherit the Jannah that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala prepared for the believers and to forgive his father because indeed he was among the deviants. And as we know later on, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala revealed to Ibrahim alayhi salam that it's not permissible to make dua for someone that is already among the people of the Hellfire. And also he made dua to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala not to disgrace him in the day of resurrection, the day when there no wealth nor offsprings would benefit the person except those who come with a sound heart. And the sound heart is the heart that has no shirk associating partners with it, no nifaq, no hypocrisy, purified from sins by repenting to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala by the forgiveness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And then the verses talks about the Jannah is draw near to the people of taqwa, those who fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and the hellfire will be made apparent to the deviant ones. And the deviant ones, it will be said to them, where are the things that you used to worship besides Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? Would they aid you? Would they help you? Or themselves, they need help. So all of them will be thrown into the hellfire, overturned into the hellfire. And also with them, the deputies of Iblis, Shaytan, all of them would be thrown into the hellfire and they would dispute in the hellfire, cursing one another. They would say that indeed by Allah we were in clear astray when we used to equate you with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the Lord of the Alameen. And the criminal ones are the ones that deviated us. There's no shafi'een for them. There's no intercessors for them. There's no devoted friend for them. Nothing whatsoever except the hellfire forever for them. And they would say that if we have another chance, we will be among the believers. But it's too late for them. Indeed, in this is a sign from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. What we just heard is a sign from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that we need to be, to act upon it. But most of the people are not believers. And indeed, your Lord is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the Almighty, the Most Merciful. Then Nuh alayhi salam is mentioned, one of the messengers of Allah, one of the great messengers of Allah. When he was sent to his people and he said to them, you know, to fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, indeed I'm a messenger of Allah, trustworthy one. So fear Allah, be dutiful to Allah and be obedient to Allah. I don't ask you for any payment or any wages. Indeed my payment, my rewards is with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So fear Allah and it's repeated again. Have the taqwa of Allah. Worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala alone. Be obedient to Allah. So they replied by saying, would we believe in you when those who are weak and oppressed are the ones that are following you? It's always one of the doubtful things for these people of elite and power. They always look down at those who are less than them. And when they see the believers are weak or poor, they would take this as an evidence that how can we follow you? It's all because of the arrogance in the hearts. In the next page, it continues with what's mentioned about Nuh alayhi salam and then the people of Ad, and page number 372. And Sheikh Taha, go ahead and recite for us.
أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم قال وما علمي بما كانوا يعملون إن حسابهم إلا على ربي لو تشعرون وما أنا بطارد المؤمنين إن أنا إلا نذير مبين قالوا لئن لم تنته يا نوح لتكونن من المرجومين قال رب إن قومي كذبون فافتح بيني وبينهم فتحا ونجني ومن معي من المؤمنين فأنجيناه ومن معه في الفلك المشحون ثم أغرقنا بعد الباقين إن في ذلك لآية وما كان أكثرهم مؤمنين وإن ربك لهو العزيز الرحيم كذبت عاد المرسلين إذ قال لهم أخوهم هود ألا تتقون إني لكم رسول أمين فاتقوا الله وأطيعون وما أسألكم عليه من أجر إن أجري إلا على رب العالمين أتبنون بكل ريع آية تعبثون وتتخذون مصانع لعلكم تخلدون وإذا بطشتم بطشتم جبارين فاتقوا الله وأطيعون واتقوا الذي أمدكم بما تعلمون أمدكم بأنعام وبنين وجن وعيون إني أخاف عليكم عذاب يوم عظيم قالوا سواء علينا أوعظت أم لم تكن من الواعظين
May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala reward you. Beautiful recitation. The people of Nuh, they said to him, after they told him, we believe in you when those who are less level of wealth and status in the society followed you. He said, what is my knowledge in what they used to do? That means their reckoning is with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. I'm not going to push away the believers. He's a messenger to everyone. their argument has no basis to it whatsoever. And he said, I'm nothing but a clear warner. So they said to Nuh alayhi salam, if you don't stop, meaning in your da'wah and calling to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, you will be among those who are stoned. So Nuh alayhi salam made dua to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that my people denied me, believed, disbelieved in me. So make a judgment between me and them and save me and who are with me from among the believers. And again, as a reminder that Nuh alayhi salam, he called his people for 950 years. It's not like once they said that to him, he immediately made dua to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for their destruction. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala saved him and those who are with him in the ship, and the rest, they were drowned. And indeed, there is an ayah, there's a sign from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Most of the people, they were not believers. And indeed, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the Almighty, the Most Merciful. Then the people of Ad are mentioned, was sent to them, Hud alayhi salam. By the way, in the verses, it says that, for example, the people of Ad, they disbelieved in the Mursaleen, all of the messengers of Allah, even though it was Prophet Hud that was sent to them, which shows that disbelieving in one messenger is exactly the same as disbelieving in all of the messengers of Allah. For those who disbelieved in Prophet Isa alayhi salam, they disbelieved in all of the messengers of Allah. And those who disbelieved in Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam, they disbelieved in all of the messengers of Allah, and so on. So then he called his people. The same thing is repeated in the surah, where he said to his people that I'm a clear messenger from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to you. So fear Allah, worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala alone. Be obedient to Allah. I don't ask you for any payment. My reward is from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And then he said to his people, you're building on elevations, all kinds of lofty things. One of the things that the people of Ad, they were so humongous and they were doing things out of to show their power. And it was said in Tafsir, one of the meanings of the verse is that they would find the elevated areas where people, when they're traveling, they would look up into these elevated areas and they would build very strong, lofty things for no reason. Not houses or anything, just to show their power. So he was condemning that for them. Why would you waste, you know, your energy and your power and your wealth for something that is no benefit whatsoever? And also that you would carve in the mountains your homes in such a very powerful and a very, in an excessive way, as if you're going to live forever, you know, forbidding them from this extremely luxurious thing that has no benefit to it whatsoever. And we can take lesson from that in our life, of course. And at the same time, whenever you revenge in such a severe way. So he reminded them to fear Allah, to be obedient to Allah, and to pay attention to what has been given to them from the favors of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he gave them all kinds of things, livestock and offsprings and gardens and springs. And because he is one of them and he's the best of them, he has the concern towards them. This is how the messengers of Allah are. He said, I fear for you the punishment of a great day. So instead of them, you know, accepting his message, they said, whether you admonish us, whether you remind us or not, it's the same to us. That means they did not take any word of what he said whatsoever. And then they continue with what evil response that they had to him and what happened to them. And after that, they mention of the people of Thamud, which is in the next page, page 373. Sheikh Abdul Razak, go ahead and recite for us.
أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم إن هذا إلا خلق الأولين وما نحن بمعذبين فكذبوه فأهلكناهم إن في ذلك لآية وما كان أكثرهم مؤمنين وإن ربك لهو العزيز الرحيم كذبت ثمود المرسلين إذ قال لهم أخوهم صالح ألا تتقون إني لكم رسول أمين فاتقوا الله وأطيعون وما أسألكم عليه من أجر إن أجري إلا على رب العالمين أتتركون فيما هاهنا آمنين في جنات وعيون وزروع ونخل طلعها هضيم وتنحتون من الجبال بيوتا فارهين فاتقوا الله وأطيعون ولا تطيعوا أمر المسرفين الذين يفسدون في الأرض ولا يصلحون قالوا إنما أنت من المسحرين ما أنت إلا بشر مثلنا فأت بآية إن كنت من الصادقين قال هذه ناقة لها شرب ولكم شرب يوم معلوم ولا تمسوها بسوء فيأخذكم عذاب يوم عظيم فعقروها فأصبحوا نادمين فأخذهم العذاب إن في ذلك لآية وما كان أكثرهم مؤمنين وإن ربك لهو العزيز الرحيم
بارك الله فيك جزاكم الله خيرا The people of Hud, they said that this is basically the customs of those who are in the past and they're not going to be punished. So they disbelieved in him. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala destroyed them. And again, this is a sign from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Most of them, they were not believers. And indeed, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the Almighty, the most merciful. Then Thamud, the people of Thamud, they also disbelieved in the messengers of Allah when it was sent to them from one from among them, their brother Salih. And shouldn't they fear Allah and be obedient to Allah? He said to them that he is a messenger from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, trustworthy, so worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala alone, obey Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He doesn't ask them for any wages. The reward is from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Then the verses talks about what some of the things that the people of Thamud were upon. He said that you are basically enjoying the favors of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, gardens and springs and all kinds of fruits and palm trees. And it's softened, the fruits of it is softened for you. And you carve in the mountains, your homes in such a powerful way. So fear Allah, be dutiful to Allah, be thankful to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And do not obey those who their matters is in an excessive way. Those who spread corruption on the face of earth and they do not do righteousness. So again, the reply is totally in a different way. As always, the ways of the disbelievers, they said you have been touched with magic. You are nothing but another human being like us. So bring us with a sign or something if you are truthful. So then he brings them a sign, which is a she-camel. And he said to them that it has its time to drink and you have your time to drink. And do not touch it with any harm. Otherwise, a severe punishment will afflict you. So they hamstrung it. So the punishment of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala came to them and they regretted it, but it was too late for them. So indeed, also in this is a sign from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. see how things are, and the matter is a continuous way when it comes to the ways of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala on the face of earth. And indeed, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the Almighty, the Most Merciful. Next page, page 374, and this will have in it Lut alayhi salam and Prophet Shu'aib. But we'll go to break first, inshallah, and come back with page 374. So stay with us, inshallah.
وذلك هو الفوز العظيم وذلك هو الفوز العظيم
الحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله. Welcome back, and with page number 374 in Surah Ash-Shu'ara, this beautiful surah that talks about some of the messengers of Allah and some of the stories mentioned in brief. And we are in need of that, and it's repeated over and over again that this is a sign from Allah. And most people are not believers, so we need to witness the benefits that we can learn from these stories to be humbled, to be obedient to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So again, page 374 in Surah Ash-Shu'ara. And Sheikh Ahmed, go ahead and recite for us, inshallah.
أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم كذبت قوم لوط المرسلين إذ قال لهم أخوهم لوط ألا تتقون إني لكم رسول أمين فاتقوا الله وأطيعون وما أسألكم عليه من أجر إن أجري إلا على رب العالمين أتأتون الذكران من العالمين وتذرون ما خلق لكم ربكم من أزواجكم بل أنتم قوم عادون قالوا لئن لم تنته يا لوط لتكونن من المخرجين قال إني لعملكم من القالين رب نجني وأهلي مما يعملون فنجيناه وأهله أجمعين إلا عجوزا في الغابرين إلا عجوزا في الغابرين ثم دمرنا الآخرين وأمطرنا عليهم مطرا فساء مطر المنذرين إن في ذلك لآية وما كان أكثرهم مؤمنين وإن ربك لهو العزيز الرحيم كذب أصحاب الأيكة المرسلين إذ قال لهم شعيب ألا تتقون إني لكم رسول أمين فاتقوا الله وأطيعون وما أسألكم عليه من أجر إن أجري إلا على رب العالمين وما أسألكم عليه من أجر إن أجري إلا على رب العالمين أوفوا الكيل ولا تكونوا من المخسرين وزنوا بالقسطاس المستقيم ولا تبخسوا الناس أشياءهم ولا تعثوا في الأرض مفسدين.
سبحانه وتعالى. Would you? At first, the mention of the people of Lut. And Lut alayhi salam, he is one of them, وانا عايز الله سبحانه وتعالى says إذ قال لهم أخوهم لوط ألا تتقون. That when his their brother Lut, he said to them, don't you fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? Don't you worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and fear and be dutiful to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? Indeed, I'm a messenger to you, a trustworthy one. So worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, be obedient to him. I don't ask you for any wages. My reward is by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Then he invited them to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, forbidding them from this evil action in which they would have relations, males to males. Relations, as he said, that none of the people before you did such an evil crime. And you leave your mates that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala created for you, which is the normal way that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala created males and females for them to get married. You are indeed people of transgression. You transgressed against the pure nature that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala created you upon. So they said to Lut alayhi salam that if you don't stop, we will excel you out of our town, evict you from our place. And he said, to them that asking Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala save him from what they're doing. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala saved Lut alayhi salam except his wife, because she approved what his people were upon. The rest were destroyed and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala perished them. And indeed, they have been warned and they didn't take the warning seriously, and the punishment of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala came to them. And this is a sign from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Most of the people are not believers. And indeed, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the Almighty, the most merciful. Then the people of Madian are mentioned. When their brother Shu'aib, their prophet, he came to them and he was sent by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to call them to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The same thing is mentioned, to fear Allah, to worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala alone, to be obedient to Allah. He does not ask them for any payment. His reward is by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Then commanding them to be just in their balance and not to take anything of it or to cheat in the balance when they're dealing and buying and selling, and to be upright in this matter and do not give people less what they deserve and do not spread corruption on the face of earth. This is how the messengers of Allah, they call their people to be upright, to worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala alone, the one that created them, and to deal with people in the best way and form. And after that, the next page, which is page 375, continuing with that and some of the lessons learned from the surah. And still we have two pages left. And Sheikh Asad, go ahead and recite for us, inshallah.
أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. واتقوا الذي خلقكم والجبلة الأولين. قالوا إنما أنت من المسحرين. وما أنت إلا بشر مثلنا وإن نظنك لمن الكاذبين. فأسقط علينا كسفا من السماء إن كنت من الصادقين. قال ربي أعلم بما تعملون. فكذبوه فأخذهم عذاب يوم الظلة إنه كان عذاب يوم عظيم. إن في ذلك لآية وما كان أكثرهم مؤمنين. وإن ربك لهو العزيز الرحيم. وإنه لتنزيل رب العالمين. نزل به الروح الأمين. نزل به الروح الأمين على قلبك لتكون من المنذرين. بلسان عربي مبين. وإن إنه لفي زبر الأولين. أولم يكن لهم آية أن يعلمه علماء بني إسرائيل. ولو نزلناه على بعض الأعجمين. فقرأه عليهم ما كانوا به مؤمنين. كذلك سلكناه في قلوب المجرمين. كذلك سلكناه في قلوب المجرمين لا يؤمنون به حتى يروا العذاب الأليم فيأتيهم بغتة وهم لا يشعرون فيقولوا هل نحن منظرون أفبعذابنا يستعجلون أفرأيت إن متعناهم سنين ثم جاءهم ما كانوا يوعدون.
بارك الله فيك، جزاكم الله خيرا. So here again, the people of Madian and their prophet Shu'aib, he is inviting them to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and saying to them to fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and to shield themselves from the punishment of Allah, the one that created them and created those who before them. So the same reply, the same old thing from every messenger and the other, that the people would say, you have been afflicted with magic, you have been, you know, magicians had afflicted you, you are nothing but a human being like us, and we think that you're a liar. And then they asked for the punishment, and they said to Shu'aib alayhi salam to bring on top of them fragments of the skies to fall on top of them if you are truthful ones. So he said to them, my Lord, he knows best of what you're doing. The Messenger of Allah is not the one that brings the punishment, it's Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So when they disbelieved in him, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala punished them from what they asked for, which is عذاب يوم الظلة. Like a cloud came on top of them, and before that it was said that they were afflicted with 7 days of extreme heat. And then when they saw this cloud coming, and they were rejoicing because now there is shade, and they went all of them till they were underneath that cloud, then the punishment of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala came down onto them, whether it's something that burned them all or something of that nature, and this is what it's called. So this was a severe punishment on that day for them, and this is a sign from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Most of them, they were not believers, and indeed Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the Almighty and He's the most merciful. Then the verses talks about the Quran, that indeed this is revelation, came down from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the Lord of the Alameen. Jibreel alayhi salam, he is the trustworthy spirit that came down with the Quran onto the heart of the Prophet alayhi salat wa salam to be among the warners with clear Arabic tongue, very clear. And indeed this is also in the previous books. And then also Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says that the people of knowledge among the people of Bani Israel, they knew about this, that this is the truth. Like Salman al-Farisi, Abdullah ibn Salam and others. And saying that if this Quran was revealed and brought down on some of those of the non-Arab speaking people, the people of Quraysh would not believe in it also, and they would say something about it. So it's not about this or that, it's about arrogance and stubbornness. And this is how it's inserted in the hearts of the criminal ones. They don't believe till they see the punishment, as the nations before. And this is one of the great lessons to be for us to learn, that all of these nations, they did not believe in the punishment of Allah till they get to see it with their own eyes. But when they got to see it with their own eyes, it was too late for them. And they did not take heed before that. And then saying that, you know, is there any reprieve for them? They're asking in haste for the punishment of Allah. Then beautiful verses that says, say, if we make them enjoy themselves for years, which is the life on the face of earth, is counted in years, not even in hundreds of years. If they are given all kinds of enjoyment in it, and then came to them what they have been promised, which is the punishment of Allah, as mentioned in the previous verses with the previous messengers, it would not avail them what they used to enjoy. What they used to enjoy before, it would be then of no benefit whatsoever. And this is where it's mentioned in the next page, 376, and the last page of Surah Ash-Shu'ara. And Shaykh Taha, go ahead and recite for us, inshallah.
A'udhu billahi minash shaytanir rajeem. Ma aghna anhum ma kanu yumatta'un. Wa ma ahlakna min qaryatin illa laha munzirun. ذكرى وما كنا ظالمين وما تنزلت به الشياطين وما ينبغي لهم وما يستطيعون إنهم عن السمع لمعزولون فلا تدع مع الله إلها آخر فتكون من المعذبين وأنذر عشيرتك الأقربين واخفض جناحك لمن اتبعك من المؤمنين فإن عصوك فقل إني بريء مما تعملون وتوكل على العزيز الرحيم الذي يراك حين تقوم وتقلبك في الساجدين إنه هو السميع العليم هل أنبئكم على من تنزل الشياطين تنزل على كل أفاك أثيم يلقون السمع وأكثرهم كاذبون والشعراء يتبعهم الغاوون ألم تر أنهم في كل وادي يهيمون وأنهم يقولون ما لا يفعلون إلا الذين آمنوا وعملوا الصالحات وذكروا الله كثيرا وانتصروا من بعد ما ظلموا وسيعلم الذين ظلموا أي منقلب ينقلبون
إن شاء الله بارك الله فيك من أسمات هذه الوجه This is the last page in سورة الشعراء and is the continuation of this beautiful statement about what if they are given the adornment and the enjoyment to the max in this life it's only in counted years And then came to them what they have been promised, which is the punishment of Allah. It did not avail them what they used to enjoy. So to take a lesson from this so that we humble ourselves and to have the hearts attached to the hereafter. And then the verses talks about those who were destroyed, as we heard in the surah. They have been sent to them warners. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the most just. And that's a reminder. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala did not treat them with injustice, one warner after the other. And they've been given the opportunity for them to repent to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, but they basically asked for the punishment themselves. And that the shayateen have no power to bring down the revelation from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. They are totally away from listening to even what the angels they say from the commands of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So therefore, do not invoke anyone but Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Otherwise, you will be among those who are punished. And commending the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam to warn his close kindred And mankind, this is basically the message of the Prophet ﷺ to reach and to lower his wing to those who followed him from the believers. And if they disobey you, O Muhammad ﷺ, then say that I disloyal myself from what you do. Rely upon Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the Almighty, the most merciful, the one that sees you when you get up for salah. And he is the one that sees you when you are making your sujood, the night prayer and salah. Even when the Prophet ﷺ was able to see those who are behind him when he is in salah. Indeed, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the all-hearer, the all-knower. And then the verses talks about those who, the shayateen, the devils, they come down unto them to whisper to them, to lead them into their destruction and deviation, are the liars, those who are constantly committing sins. And then the poets are mentioned, those who, the deviant ones, they follow them because they, whatever it takes them, You know, the opinions of people, the ways of people that are going with it. You know, they write poetry, lying, they would appease to some, those who are evil or the other, they don't have a principle where they follow. And this is what is in general, except, so it's not all poets or all poetry is bad, except those who believe and do righteous good deeds, and they make lots of remembrance to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and are upon what is upright after they have been treated with injustice. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the surah ends with saying that those who transgressed upon themselves, those who wronged themselves, they will know what is really the outcome that is waiting for them. So as if this is the message that we are taking or getting from the surah, the outcome of things. And that's why more than one prophet and his people have been mentioned to see the outcome, what happened when they disbelieved in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And this is from the signs of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And they will know, the wrongdoers, the believers, because they know, and that's what is the major difference between the believers and the disbelievers. The believers, when they see the revelation from Allah and they know what's coming ahead, so they would act now accordingly. The disbelievers are forgetful. They overlook it and they make mockery of it, and it will happen. And when it happens, only the disbelievers, the wrongdoers, will be afflicted by the punishment of Allah. The next page, 377, which is the first page in Surat An-Naml, and Sheikh Abdul Razak, go ahead and recite for us, inshallah.
أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم طسم تلك آيات القرآن وكتاب هدى وبشرى للمؤمنين الذين يقيمون الصلاة ويؤتون الزكاة وهم بالآخرة هم يوقنون إن الذين لا يؤمنون بالآخرة زينا لهم أعمالهم فهم يعمهون أولئك الذين لهم سوء العذاب أولئك الذين لهم سوء العذاب وهم في الآخرة هم الأخسرون وإنك لتلقى القرآن من لدن حكيم عليم إذ قال موسى لأهله إني آنست نارا سآتيكم منها بخبر أو آتيكم بشهاب قبس أو آتيكم بشهاب قبس لعلكم تصطلون فلما جاءها نودي أن بورك من في النار ومن حولها فلما جاءها نودي أن بورك من في النار ومن حولها وسبحان الله رب العالمين يا موسى إنه أنا الله العزيز الحكيم وألق عصاك فلما رآها تهتز كأنها جان كأنها جان ولا مدبرا ولم يعقب يا موسى لا تخف إني لا يخاف لدي المرسلون إلا من ظلم ثم بدل حسنا بعد سوء فإني غفور رحيم وأدخل يدك في جيبك تخرج بيضاء من غير سوء في تسع آيات إلى فرعون وقومه إنهم كانوا قوما فاسقين فلما جاءتهم آياتنا مبصرة قالوا هذا سحر مبين.
The beginning of Surah An-Naml. An-Naml is basically the ants, and it's mentioned in the Surah as it will come, inshallah ta'ala. And it starts with two letters, as many of the Surahs in the Quran that starts with letters. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala knows best the meanings of it, but it's from the same letters that the Quran is made from, which is the Arabic language, challenging the people to bring the like of it. So these are ayat of the Quran, and a clear book from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Some of the characteristics of the Quran, guidance, and it gives glad tidings to the believers, those who establish the salah, they give the zakah, and they have certainty in the hereafter. And indeed, warning, those who disbelieve in the hereafter, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said that their deeds are adorned for them. Their evil deeds is beautified for them, so they become like wandering blindly. And this is a severe warning. When people disbelieve in Allah, disbelieve in the last day, they become distorted in the way they see things. And they will have the worst of the punishment in the hereafter, and they will be the losers in the day of judgment. And this Quran is from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the most wise, the unknower. Then the verses talks about Musa alayhi salam, when he saw the fire when he was returning back to Egypt, and he said to his family that, let me see what's there. Maybe there is something for him, news. Or to get some fire so that they would have some form of warmth as a result of that. And once he got there, he was called that he is blessed, the one that is in the fire and around it. And it was Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala speaking to Musa alayhi salam that he is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the Almighty, the Most Wise, subhanahu wa ta'ala, and commanding him to throw his staff. And when he saw it moving like a snake, Musa alayhi salam, that he started running away, fleeing from the place. So he was called by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, O Musa, do not have fear. Indeed, the messengers of Allah, they don't fear whatsoever. They only fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, except those who transgressed and they changed the goodness and things like this. Allah subhanahu, if they repent to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the most forgiver, the most merciful. And he commanded him to put his hand in his pocket. And when it comes out, it comes with so much radiant light. And this is a sign from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala without any harm. And these are nine signs, a miraculous thing to the people of Fir'aun, and they are indeed rebellious people. But when the ayat, when the signs from Allah came to them very clearly, they said this is clear sorcery, as also we heard in the previous surah. So the ways of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala are explained, the characteristics of the believers, some of the mention of the stories of the Quran, and it will come inshallah ta'ala more in the next pages. But we'll stop here inshallah ta'ala for this episode, and next time we'll continue inshallah ta'ala with Surah An-Naml. And before we end, I would like to thank the reciters with us. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala reward you all for coming. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make it in the balance of your good deeds. Until next time, we leave you with the protection of Allah. Wa sallallahu wa sallam wa baraka ala Muhammadin وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم، والسلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته.
الله نزل أحسن الحديث كتابا متشابها مثانية تقشعر منه جلود الذين يخشون ربهم مثانية تقشعر منه جلود الذين يخشون ربهم ثم تلين جلودهم وقلوبهم